What is the soul? Where is the center of its existence? And what is its function?
A dialogue between the great scholar Muhammad Amin Shaikho and the 20th century philosopher Sir John Godolphin Bennett.
However, as I mentioned to you, I still have further burning questions which have caused me great anxiety for many years. If you will do me the honour of spending more of your time enlightening me, I will be most grateful. The next question I wish to ask concerns the soul. What exactly is the soul? Where is the centre of its existence? And what is its function?
Of course, I'm happy to continue to assist you in your search for religious truth. As for the soul, it is the support of the godly light which flows into the blood. Its center in the body is the physical heart, and it is the power that animates all the systems and cells of the body. It moves through the body and nourishes it, so the life of the body depends on it. It is the executive power of the purpose, requirements, demands, and desires of the spirit. The soul is under the command of the spirit that moves within the nerves by sending its rays through the nervous system. The spirit directs and controls all the voluntary and involuntary organs. The soul of human beings, animals, and all living creatures is the same. But in the prophets and apostles, it is a sacred soul. That is, it is removed from impurities and is without low purposes, because the souls of these people have not been contaminated by the worldly stains of life and its evil. These souls remain virtuous, pure and sacred, so that they only express goodness, righteousness, virtue and perfection. Wherever they settle, goodness, bliss, blessings, happiness, and the delightful eternal beatitude of Allah spread on all those who direct themselves towards them, and all those who are around them.
Can you please speak more about the soul with reference to your Prophet Muhammad and using Quranic references?
As for the Prophet Muhammad, communication with Allah and peace are through him, he explained the soul and its rays flowing through the body by the means of blood. The prophetic saying reads, "Satan flows through a son of Adam like the blood circulates in the body." And that is referred to in the noble verse in the Holy Quran, Fortress 17, Al-Isra, the Night Journey, verse 85. They ask thee concerning the soul. Say, the soul is of the command of my provider. It is only too little omniscience that is got to you. They ask thee concerning the soul. They really asked him about it to frustrate and defeat him. But God the Almighty answered, says to them, the soul is at the command of my provider. The words, the command of my provider, indicate providence and show that godly support spreads throughout existence. The animation and life of a human being, as well as all living creatures, encompassing man, animals, and plants, are all only possible with the support of God the Almighty. Motion does not take place except through His provision and with His command. If God withdrew His support, that is to say the soul, from the creation of the earth, they would become motionless, lifeless, and nothing. The existence of the soul in creation is like the electric current which moves all machines that are operated by electricity. If power is disconnected, the machines stop and become motionless. Similarly, the soul in the body is poured into the heart of the human being and its rays flow into the blood, which then carries nourishment and oxygen to all parts of the body and takes away the wastes and poisons that are to be rejected from the body through urination and exhalation. In the Quranic verse, the phrase, is at the command of my provider refers to this supply to the heart and blood which completes the circle of life. If that supply to living creation is stopped, they will become lifeless and motionless. The meaning of the word soul, as mentioned in the Holy Quran, differs according to its treatment in the verses. The soul in general is the support for life which can be either for the physical heart or for the core of the spirit, as the Almighty says in the noble verse in the Holy Quran, Fortress 40, the Ghafir, the Forgiver, God, verse 15. Raised high above ranks, he is the owner of the beautiful godly revelation. Of his command, he lets the soul descend upon whom he pleases of his obedient men, so as to warn of the day of meeting. This asserts what we have said. God's saying is, from the Holy Quran, Fortress 4, and Nisa, Women, verse 171. The Messiah, Jesus, son of Mary, was no more than a messenger of Allah and his word, which he bestowed on Mary and was a soul created by him. This soul is nothing more than that godly provision which Allah provided to our Master Jesus, peace is through him, through our Master Gabriel, peace is through him. After explaining that to them, he replied, "It is only too little omniscience that has got to you, human beings." The statement, "It is only too little omniscience that has got to you," does not address the Prophet of God, but those who ask, because it comes in the plural form in the original Arabic. If it had meant the Prophet, communication with Allah and peace are through him, it would have come in the singular. He is the speaker. The meaning is, say to them, Muhammad, it is only too little omniscience that has got to you, meaning the challengers.
Thank you again for imparting more of your great wisdom. I feel that I am beginning to have a much better understanding, but I still have much to learn. There is so much understanding and knowledge to be found in your Holy Quran. So it appears to me now that the soul is the means by which we achieve closeness to God?
In brief, we say that if man thinks deeply and thoroughly of this universe, his speculation and contemplation will lead him to the fact that there is a great creator and a wise disposer. Then his way will become straight, and this straightness will generate good actions and trust in God's satisfaction with him. These actions and trust become man's means to get nearer to God, and he acquires perfection from his Creator through communication with him. Then he loves those who possess perfection, and the master of perfection, the Prophet Muhammad, communication with Allah and peace are through him. Thus his spirit accompanies the spirit of the Prophet, who is always close to Allah. And then he sees the luminous provision of God that is prevalent in everything in existence. This is what we call the soul.
I am impressed with your great knowledge of the spirit and the soul, and I want to thank you again for your clear explanations of these matters.
From the aforementioned, it is clear to us that there is a great difference and contrast between the soul and the spirit. In fact, this thing was not clarified by anyone, since the Master of Prophets, communication with Allah and peace are through them, or before this great man, Muhammad Amin Sheikho. And this matter thunderstruck scientists and thinkers and captivated Sir John Bennett. La ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasul.